Simon Klimt joins us in the Sydney studio to discuss Pacific American Coal. Simon, welcome back. I see you finished drilling at the Coking Coal Project at Elko in Canada. What are the early indications from the drilling?
The indications are really quite positive. So all of the holes we drilled intersected multiple coal seams, which is what we expected, but it appears that they really have hit what we were looking for. It's a bit of correlation still to be done when we get the assay results back, which will then ultimately feed into our JORC resource numbers early in the new year, but it's looking really positive at the moment.
How have you got these early indications back if assays aren't ready yet?
Well, we've done the geophysical logging, and it's the geophysical logging that we've got that we've released to the market this week. And now it's a matter of taking those geophysical logs and correlating them with the with those assay results to feed into the JORC resource that we expect to be able to update early in the new year.
Remind us about the resource that you do have there at Elko, and tell us about your expectations for the upgrade.
Well, Elko has always looked like a really world-class project. We started with an initial JORC resource of over 250 million tonnes, and it's good coking, good quality coking coal in the top seams, and that's what we've really been focusing on this drill program. And the drill program, as I think I mentioned in one of our previous interviews, was all about trying to get more definition around those top target seams. And that's really what we've been doing, and some of these results are showing that out at the moment.
We did notice that you sold off your South Hazel exploration tenements, so you could push that cash into Elko. Tell us about the priority on that, about that exploration program moving forwards.
Well, that's right. We did monetize the Elko, South Hazel project. And that was because we got a good offer, and we saw better opportunity with putting that cash into Elko, which is what we've done. We're going to take the results now that we've got from Elko, as we said, put them into the JORC statement, but also use them as a basis for trying to determine what the next phases of that exploration program are, which we'll announce in due course once we've got all of the results.
And let's remind the viewers about coking coal as an asset. It is separate from thermal coal. Tell us about the markets.
Well, that's a point that we make on a regular basis. We really are a metallurgical and coking coal company. We don't have any thermal coal in our portfolio. And as we like to say, coking coal is really very, very different to thermal coal. It is really more tied to industrial demand and steel demand around the world. And as we like to also point out, and in fact the government pointed out in their recent resource quarterly, there's over 200 tonnes of metallurgical coal goes into every wind turbine that's built because of the amount of steel that goes into them. So metallurgical coal is a very, very important component of industrial production and infrastructure, and the world is still really spending quite a lot on those things, and so that's why we see a really significant future for coking coal and the Elko project as part of that.
So Simon, you've told us we can expect assay results and the upgraded JORC at the start of the new year. Tell us about those other milestones, more medium and long term, to getting into full production.
Well, the results will be really important. We've also taken core from one of the major holes in the program that we've just completed. The core and the other geological data that we get out of this program will be used for the discussions with potential partners, and that'll also help us with what the next phases of the exploration program are. So from here, we do a lot more on the geology as well as the commercial aspects of the project.
Simon Klimt, thank you.
Thank you.